Let's look at Mattress Running the Numbers. So this week for Mattress Running the Numbers, we've got something from Hilton, right? There's some stacking Hilton opportunities.
Yeah. Yeah. So this is interesting. So there's an Amex offer out that basically saves you 20%, up to 20% on a Hilton stay, because the way it works is you get, you know, if you spend $250, you get back, I don't know, whatever 20% of that is. And
$50.
And there's a couple variations on it at different Hilton properties, but they all work out to, if you maximize it exactly, it's a 20% rebate. Okay. And the other thing is, Stephen found and posted that there's a link that lets you add these offers to your Hilton Aspire card. So most of these offers don't necessarily show up automatically if you have the top tier Hilton Aspire credit card, but it's pretty exciting if you get an offer like this on there, right? Because Hilton Aspire offers 14 points per dollar at Hilton properties, you know, so you get both that plus the Amex rebate, plus if you still have your resort credit and you stay at a resort property, you're getting up to $250 back a year with the Hilton Aspire card. So that combination is pretty awesome. And then all of the stacks, if you had enrolled in your Hilton double or triple points promo that's still going on through, I think, September 5th or so, then as long as you book a 3-night stay or more, you get triple points. Less than that, you get double points. And so you could get up to 54 points per dollar. That's if you have the Aspire card, and that's partly because you have diamond status. And so that gets you bonus points. You're paying with the Aspire card, getting the 14 points per dollar. And now you're getting this like triple points promo. So all these things stack up to 54 points per dollar, which is pretty spectacular. So the question on the table is all of this together Mattress Run worthy?
Well, you know, when you first started talking about this, when we first looked at this, I was like, oh yeah, that actually sounds pretty interesting. Now, I have a question to propose maybe at the end. Maybe I should propose it now because it'll explain why I'm going to do the math the way I am. Do you know, because I don't know the answer to this, if you have, let's say you have that Amex offer for 50 back on 250 and you spend exactly 250 at a Hilton resort, will you get $300 back? Will you get your $250 Aspire credit plus the $50 Amex offer? Now, yeah, the answer is yes, you would, because it triggers the Amex offer. But the reason I'm asking is because in the past with Dell, Amex hasn't liked it when you came out profitable and has clawed back on people.
Right.
Now, in my case, I have stacked those two things, but never on a stay that was that cheap. It was always on stays that were more expensive and, you know, just saved me some money. So,
yep.
I don't know if Amex will claw back if you try to come out $50 ahead on that. So what I'm going to do for the purposes of the math is assume that you book a $300 stay at a Hilton resort. Okay. So you book a $300 stay, get $50 back from the Amex offer, $250 back if you've got the Hilton Aspire resort credit. Worth noting that you need to go and look at the Hilton resorts. There's a resorts page. If you go to our Aspire card page, you'll find a link to it somewhere. And you want to check, because not every place that's called a resort is a resort, and not every place that is a resort says that it's a resort or intuitively seems like a resort. So that's worth mentioning. Anyway, so you book a $300 stay at one of those places, get your $300 back. And if you're getting 54 points per dollar, then you end up with 16,200 Hilton points. And for a minute, I was like, you know, if you're not planning to use your Aspire credit this year, you can effectively turn that credit into 16,200 points that you can use later, stack into a more valuable redemption, et cetera, et cetera. So I was going to say, well, yeah, if you're not going to use it, why not turn it into some points? Except that I did the math and I was like, okay, well, 16,200 points, that's worth like $81. So trading your $250.
And that's if you're very generously calling them half a cent each.
Half a cent. Right. Right. And whereas we really
our current
what?
Right. Our current RRV is 0.4. So yeah, 0.4 of a cent. Yeah.
So even less, 65, 70 ish, somewhere in there at the 0.4. Right. So not that much. It's not worth that much. So you're trading in $250 worth of credit for very little in points. And so that made me less excited when I actually thought about it, because as I've pointed out before, you can use that resort credit this year if you book a resort for sometime next year that requires a deposit.
Yeah.
Not all hotels that require a deposit are non-refundable. Some will charge a deposit, or even you may book a hotel that doesn't have a deposit. You may be able to reach out and ask them if they will take a deposit from you. And of course, if they do that, they will give it back if you later have to cancel your stay. But so even if you're not planning a stay this year, you can look way out into the future, book a stay way out for next year, and try to get a full $250 in value out of that. I wouldn't trade it for $81 worth of points, would you?
Oh, no, I wouldn't. but let's talk about how good this is as a rebate, and how it's not as completely impractical as it sounds if you're in two-player mode. So if you and your significant other both have the Aspire card, then you could book a single three-night stay and at checkout, you know, divide the spend across the two. And I'm bringing that up because, remember, to get the full 54 points per dollar needs to be a three-night stay at a resort that triggers the credit. So we're talking about, you know, trying to get a three-night stay for $300 after taxes is kind of silly, especially in these days. And so, you know, getting one for $600 is probably also pretty unlikely, but at least it's towards more the realm likely of theoretically possible. Right. And then
particularly if you're traveling overseas, if you are traveling overseas this year, I'm finding, more I look at stuff, that there are some really reasonable prices overseas. Like, I was looking at a rental car in the US, and I was looking at like $100 a day for an intermediate car. If I wanted a minivan, it's gonna be like $200 a day. Right.
Right.
And I or closer to that anyway. And then I was looking at one overseas, and I was looking at like $20 a day.
Right,
amazing. So, yeah. And the same kind of thing is happening in some cases with hotels. So you might be able to book a resort overseas somewhere for a reasonable price.
Yeah,
so,
and actually probably in Mexico, there's probably plenty of availability for that type of rate. So if you look at it, even without the Aspire credit, if you could do this, you're looking at 20% back from the Amex offer, plus, depending on how you value the Hilton points, 22% at our valuation, or 27% back at a half cent per point value. So let's just call that 25% to be in between the two. And so we're looking at about a 45% rebate on that kind of stay. And then plus you get to use your, you know, some amount of your credits if you haven't already. So it's a pretty nice deal. But yeah, I wouldn't see it as mattress run worthy, but a way to get a really nice rebate on a resort stay.
For sure. Yeah, a very nice rebate. So it's totally worth it if you are looking to stay at a resort and one that, you know, fits the price point, your needs matches here, then yeah, I mean, of course, it's a great rebate. You know, nice to walk out with all those points and money in your pocket. So
for sure,
worth looking at, not worth booking if you don't have any need for the stay.
Right, exactly.